hear me in the back?
Yeah!
Terrific. We're having some overflow issues, which is a good problem to have, so thank you for being patient as we fill this space. Welcome to you. It's so good to see you all in the audience this evening. My name is Arian Caffey. I'm Director of Choral Studies at San Diego State University, and this is our first time performing at All Souls Episcopal Church in Point Loma in this beautiful, incredible acoustic. So I'd like to just take a moment to thank the team here and the musical staff, Melissa Hall and Ruben Valenzuela. Will you please give a round of applause to them? I'm so glad to see you here this evening and to welcome you to our short teaser concert. Our mid-semester is usually our teaser as we work our way toward the end of semester. So I anticipate the concert to be about a little less than an hour, at the end of which we'll take photos and there'll be a little champagne, sparkling cider toast outside by the parish offices. I see familiar faces in the crowd. I see friends and colleagues. Hello, hello. And I see new faces. I see so many new faces. And if this is your first time coming to an SDSU choir concert, welcome to you. And I hope that you come back to more concerts for San Diego State University choirs and for San Diego State University in general. Let's just take a moment and talk about this concert. You're all no stranger to the idea that music weaves so many threads of our existence together into a single tapestry. Music is at the intersection of so many of the big issues that we talk about in our lives: war, politics, psychology, anthropology, culture. Music is at the intersection of all of these things. But music is also at the intersection of the smaller things. How you doing? How are you feeling? What's going on in your mind? How are you? And so, when I was putting our semester together and saw that March 4th was on a Saturday, on a performance weekend, I thought, there's no better opportunity to put together a concert on the only date which is both a date and a command. To put together a concert as a pick-me-up for our students who are probably going through the ringer right now in their degrees, and for all of us in the audience who are probably experiencing much the same thing in our lives as we deal with challenges. A large percentage of the rep that we perform for you this evening hopefully encourages you to find joy, to smile, to cheer up if you're feeling down, to laugh maybe even, to feel hopeful, to feel encouraged, and to march forth. And with that, I invite our university chorus, you chorus, up to come on and join me up here, please. Mangisondele Nkosiyam is a piece from South Africa. It's a praise song from the Zulu culture, and it was written in the style originating from miners and other laborers during apartheid. So that a cappella sound, that close harmony sound that you hear other than percussion, comes from this style of music. The soloists, the responsorial style of call and response is also a frequent feature of these types of work songs. With that, I would like to introduce to you Catherine Marshall, currently a master's student at San Diego State University in flute performance, but having just been accepted into the graduate degree in choral conducting, will now come on up and conduct the next piece for you.
But this will be performed all over the world during the month of May, which is the month of Mary. But we are bringing it to you here a couple months early. We hope that you enjoy.
Domine, nous te
I would like to bring to the podium Philip Lanud, who is a BM student currently in professional studies at San Diego State University, who is also assistant conducting U Chorus this semester. Please welcome Phil Lanud to the podium.
I am possibility. That's a bold statement. I am possibility. But when we drill down deeper into that word possibility, we have some thoughts. What is a possibility? It's a promise. It is an opportunity. It is a gift. And one of the greatest gifts that we can give each other as human beings is to lift each other up. All these wonderful musicians that you will hear today, we lift each other up. We lift the audience and each other up through song. But every one of you is an opportunity. Every one of you is a promise. Every one of you is a gift. And what will you do with your opportunity? As we perform this song, I'd love you to just enjoy it, let it wash over you, but also consider your possibility.
I am possibility, singing.
our quote-unquote un-audition choir. So anyone who just loves to sing can sing in this ensemble from across the university. And the ensemble has grown over the last few years. And so when I say that I am proud of these students and their work over the course of this semester, this is always one of my favorite times during the year, when I get to hear them in concert for the very first time, and some folks who haven't sung ever in a chorus before, to some folks who have sung in the chorus since middle school, but they just wanted to do it while they were getting their physics degree. Or nuclear engineering, or aerospace, or you name it. So I'm very proud of this group right here. The next piece that we would like to perform for you is two movements of five Hebrew love songs. I don't know if there are those of you in the crowd who are, but if any of you are true choir nerds who go to choir conferences, okay, probably not. But if you do someday, you're going to see a golden mane of flowing hair surrounded by throngs of fans. That is Eric Whitaker. Or it is international Israeli opera rock star Hila Plikman. It's one of those two, and they're surrounded by their claque. And in the 90s, the powerhouse of Eric Whitaker met the powerhouse that was Hila Plikman, and they formed a union. They were dating in the 1990s, in the mid-90s. And as their love was burgeoning and forming, they sat together and they conceived of these poems that you're going to hear. These little miniature fragments in Hebrew, Hila's native language. And they are small vignettes, they're little miniatures. And so, the text to the first movement, which you have in front of you, which I highly encourage you to read as you are listening to the music, a picture is engraved in my heart, moving between light and darkness, a sort of silence envelops your body and your hair falls upon your face just so. And that, I think that sensation, so many of these words in this poem, these very visceral words, these evocative words, are captured so beautifully in the music, to where I think that if you're listening, you will hear and feel the hair of maybe the person that you love gently brushing on their face as you maybe brush it aside. You will hear that in the music. And that first movement, that very beautiful first movement, is followed up by this gorgeous second movement, where then we have the tenors and basses singing Kala Kala, which is a Hebrew play on words, which means light and bride, light bride. And it's followed by something that will surprise you, and I'll let you just hear that as we perform for you. So I hope that you enjoy Eric Whitaker's five Hebrew love songs. last piece that you chorus will sing for you this evening is We Shall Walk in the Valley of Peace by composer Undine Smith Moore. Undine Smith Moore in her lifetime was considered the dean of black women composers. She was a fierce advocate for black music education, particularly for children. She attended Fisk University as a piano major. And later on, she was offered scholarship to attend Juilliard, which she turned down because she wanted to take a teaching position at Virginia State College at that time, now Virginia State University. While teaching music composition, counterpoint, piano at Virginia State College, she also founded the Black Music Center there and ran it until her death. She was the granddaughter of slaves and had this dissonant experience during her master's degree at the Columbia Teachers College in Columbia, where she remarked that hardly anyone knew of any of the music that she had grown up with, that she had experienced or that she had heard, and that she loved so dearly. And so she made it her mission to make choral music, and particularly the setting of spirituals, concert spirituals, and American hymnody at the center of her compositional output. Thank you so much for being here with us this evening to hear University Chorus. After University Chorus performs, we're gonna have a slight little switcheroo and then bring up Treble Choir here. So thank you very much.
Oh.
And the text of this piece comes from a quote attributed to Ray Bradbury, a great American author, novelist, who said, what did he say? He said something, and I'm paraphrasing this quote, jump off of the building, and build your wings on the way down. Which means, take a leap into faith, which means try, which means don't be bound by corporate ideas of what you can and cannot do. I have a friend in New York. She didn't have a dime to her name. She went and booked Alice Tully Hall, which is the big hall, for the New York Master Chorale, which didn't exist. But she signed off on it. But she put that $20,000 down for that hall, and she scrimped and saved to do it. And then she built the New York Master Chorale, and then they performed at Alice Tully Hall, and now they're in their 15th season. That's just one story. How many stories are here in the audience of times that you leapt and built your wings on the way down? So we hope that you enjoy our performance of Jump. A lot of it is a play on the word jump. We're just in various parts of the word jump. So we hope that you enjoy. Thank you.
Friends, before you get too comfy, typically you wouldn't sit a string quartet behind a piano because you'd want to see them and who they are. So will you please stand and be recognized, friends? Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we have one more awkward set change for you now while we go back to the original position, so please bear with us.
Thank you.
Thank you. As I said, as we go into our last piece, we are going to take a photo after this performance, followed by our toast. Thank you so much for being with us this evening. It's been a real joy to perform for you. I hope that you've had a good experience as well. Please join us again for our next concerts. Look to our Instagram page and our various social media platforms to find out more information about San Diego State University Choirs. And if you have kiddos who are going to San Diego State University, I would encourage you to encourage them to join the choirs. They're getting into a double choir formation right now, so we've split up the treble choir into two choirs, and each choir sings in three or four parts. And the piece that we're about to perform for you is Blinded by a Leafy Crown by Canadian composer Mary Claire Sandon. And this piece is by on a poem by Sarah Teasdale. And the poetry is quite beautiful. At the beginning of the piece, you're going to hear this sturdy tree that is surrounded by leaves. That's the leafy crown. And one by one, its leaves begin to shed. And these leaves represent various faiths, as the poet puts it, but faiths really mean assumptions, presuppositions, things that we're tied to in this world. And as these leaves shed one by one, suddenly the tree understands that it hadn't really been able to look up or down before because it was surrounded by these ideas that it had about the world, these presuppositions, these notions that it held onto so fiercely. And as it was then able to shed these leaves, now it can see stars above and the earth below, which the composer paints very beautifully. Thank you for being here with us this evening.